That's fine.
Anything else?
We had seen the letter from Chief McGoldrick with respect to the Heath public access. And my question is, what now? If we, one of our conditions of approval was to get a letter from the fire chief saying that there was satisfactory emergency access. I still feel comfortable with this, but he says point blank, Peebles Cove Road entrance needs work done on it. As Mr. Emery pointed out.
I looked at this and I sort of thought that it seems to be a little short of what we were looking for as far as some statement from the fire chief. Number two, would have difficulty if Highview Road was blocked. Well, have a difficulty if it were a dead-end street and there were no private road there as well. I mean, certainly the town emergency vehicles have jurisdiction over certain travel lanes and so forth, but taking it for what it is, it seemed to be a point-blank statement. I don't know, are we looking for something more? I mentioned that in when I dealt with the correspondence. I'm glad you reminded me. Is it a consensus of the board to go back and ask for something more specific? Does it satisfy? It's listed as a condition, I believe, of that approval. And that being so, if we're not satisfied with that condition being satisfied, then we go back and say, be more specific.
I'm not concerned with Mrs. Heath putting her house there, but to me this is evidence, and Mr. Drynan's application is another possibility of what you often say, Steve, over and over, is that if we want this stuff, you should get it before approval, because if you get something like this, you wonder, is your approval void? Or if we might ignore this particular comment, then why are we asking for it in the first place? So I would hope somehow we would come up with some general or standard operating procedure that we avoid this situation. And I hate to always table people for minor things, but
We're criticized for adding that extra month on to go back because we don't want to make it a condition, then we make it a condition, and it's not fully satisfied, and it becomes problematic, or can become. I guess I'm looking to the board, and I can't remember whether it was Tom or Mark who had mentioned, as far as making the
question. We have a letter from the fire chief, so that condition's been met. I guess what we need from the fire chief is correspondence directly to the board or to town planner and perhaps the police department as to specifically what. See, I don't know if he is the applicant had stated, simply says, thinks they need to clear out some brush or whether in fact the road needs some work. I think he should be specific in terms of what it is that needs to be done.
The portion of area that the applicant was going to clear is not the entrance area. And she was just going to clear out enough so that the site distance would be okay. I suspect that the kind of work that the fire chief is talking about is road construction type work.
But it came mostly into discussion in the turnaround, in the turning of emergency vehicles, I believe. I think if Chief McGoldrick could state more specifically that the turning capability at that location is either satisfactory or not, then in light of your condition, I would be more satisfied with that being met.
Is there only one side road off Eastfield to get over to the site, or aren't there two?
There are two.
So there's a
carriage.
There could be a length of the private road that could be improved. So if one of the Eastfield access routes is under fire, then the other one would still be open as long as the connection between them on the private road is cleared appropriately.
I think that's what we're looking for, something specific from the chief saying it's sufficient and we have room to turn our machinery around, or no, it's not.
he has enough room to turn his machinery around. What he can't do is bring his machinery down Peebles Cove Road between Highview and Carriage View.
I'm not sure that was a condition of the approval, that the fire access be the two accesses any more than any other. It's a dead end road of less than X number of feet, that there has to be more than one access.
I believe that Peebles Cove Road does have a loop in it, so it's not a dead end road.
Yes,
but I'm saying Highview Road. Highview Road is a dead end street.
Yep.
Is that correct? That's the dead-end street that's less than 2,000 feet long. And that being so, it is not required to have a second access. Is that right?
Right.
Can we go back to the chief and ask him to be specific about any items? Or is that the wishes of...
That's fine with me. I just want to know if it's road work or whether it's a matter of clearing in order to get his vehicles.
I would ask Maureen if you could respond to Chief McGoldrick and ask him that the board would like to see more specific comment about his access.
I think in all fairness...
Turning capability and access to the site.
I think in all fairness to the applicant, I went on at some length about sort of picking on the applicant about the issue of access from Old Ocean House Road. But I think the board in its deliberation determined that wasn't necessary, that Eastfield was acceptable. So I don't feel that it's necessary for the fire chief now to determine that he can have access from. I personally would prefer it, but I don't think it was a board's decision that the applicant has to have access, clear access from Old Ocean House.
Okay. I guess with those comments, Maureen, if you can go back to Chief McGoldrick and have him make that more clear. Any other discussion? Other comments to come before the board? Do I hear a motion to adjourn?
So moved.
Seconded?
Seconded.
All those in favor? Meeting is adjourned. Thank you very much.
The same, should we say, excitement that adults go into the TV store.
No.
They don't. Only guns, Allura, is that what you're saying?
Yeah, it's different because, I know the same kind of people who go into the computer trade shows and get all...